And this is the verdict, that the light came into the world, but people preferred darkness to light because their works were evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light and does not come toward the light. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Once again, these words of our blessed Savior, so beautifully couched in the Gospel of St. John, exemplify for us the mystical tone and tendency of this Gospel of St. John. As you know so very well, the first three Gospels, the Synoptic Gospels, are very much centered upon, of course, the work of Jesus, his interrelationship with people, his miracles, and his preaching, of course. But it is truly the Gospel of St. John that more graphically and poignantly exemplifies for us the mystical mind of Jesus. That's why the Gospel of St. John, when one reads it, one has to read it very cautiously and, of course, with great attention. Otherwise, the words overwhelm one's mind and one loses sight of what Jesus is trying to tell us, because it requires concentration and attention to understand all the subtleties and nuances in the Gospel of St. John, which really, once again to repeat myself, portray and depict for us the mind of Jesus. So my dearest friends, here we see something that is happening in the world today, that unfortunately, due to many people rejecting Jesus and his message of love, of compassion and reconciliation, and opting to continue to live life of ambition, power, greed, and avarice, and selfishness, and prejudice, we see, unfortunately, once again, that the world is going towards a precipice. A precipice that if our world does not relent and convert and change, may once again cause humanity to fall into a deep and profound conflict. We see it happening more and more. It's like everything is building up into a crescendo. And everything can be, and all of this can be absolutely avoided if we accept and integrate into our relationship with each other, whether as persons and as nations, the gospel values. It's as difficult and easy as that. But because many people do not consider, do not accept, as Jesus says, the light, he as the source of light, he is light as himself, and his teaching and gospel, we continue to therefore harvest anarchy and chaos. And that is why we Catholics and Christians in the world of today, more than ever, have to continue to pray to the Lord and hold with great strength the teachings of the gospel, and not let ourselves be led astray by all the conflicting ideologies, philosophies, and concepts that are being constantly reiterated throughout our media, throughout all different forms of communication. It is important that we ground ourselves in the truth of our faith, and that is that Jesus is truly God and truly man, that Jesus is our Savior, and that in him we have the source of life, of light, of wisdom and understanding. And let us try, if we can, in our relationships and conversations with others, to convince them of that reality as well. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Padre, Hijo y Espíritu Santo, descienda sobre nosotros. Amén.